Fatima. This is Fatima knocking at my door. وَلَقَدْ أَتَتْنَا فِي سَاعَةٍ مَا عَوَّدَتْنَا أَن تَأْتِينَا. And my Fatima has come to me today at a very unusual time. Something is bothering my Fatima. Fatima was that woman. مَنْ آذَاهَا فَقَدْ آذَانِي. Whoever has hurt Fatima has hurt me. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu intends getting married to the daughter of Abu Jahl. While Fatima radiallahu anhu is in his nikah, Nabi alayhi salam ascends the pulpit. He says, لا أحرم حلالا ولا أحلل حراما. I have no ability or authority to make something lawful unlawful, nor to make something unlawful lawful. If Ali wants to get married to the daughter of Abu Jahl, it is permissible. But my hurt is that the daughter of Muhammad and the daughter of Abu Jahl cannot share one roof. I cannot stop him, but my only cry is, my Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad and the daughter of Abu Jahl cannot share one roof. Fatima radiallahu anha knocks on the door. Nabi alayhi salam opens the door. She enters into the house. She says, O Nabi of Allah, هذه الملائكة تعامها التهليل والتسبيح والتحميد فما تعامنا. The malaika are worshiping Allah. يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفترون. What is our condition? I am hungry. Your son-in-law Ali is hungry. Your grandchildren are hungry. What does Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam say? Oh Fatima, five sheep I have before me here. If you want, choose any one of them. And if you want, علمتك خمس كلمات علمنيهن جبريل. I will teach you five words which will satisfy your hunger today also, tomorrow also, when I'm around and when I'm gone also. One was to say, have the sheep and the words. But after all, this was that Fatima who grew up in the lap of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. What is the condition of the iman of our children? What does Nabi alayhi salam give? Dua. What are those five words? Oh my father, teach me those five words. Say, oh my daughter, يا أول الأولين ويا آخر الآخرين ويا راحم المساكين ويا ذا القوة المتين. I have said it, you have heard it. Fatima has paid the price of this so she can understand the value of this. Oh my son, I give dua to you that may Allah make the pangs of death easy for you. So Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam engages his son in a discussion. Oh my son, I have seen this in a dream that I am slaughtering you. How would you respond to this? Now one is we don't introduce Allah to this child. And when this child is baligh, we impose on him to obey Allah. How can he obey Allah when he got up in an environment where there was no Allah? Ismail alayhi salam responds and he says, قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Oh my father, go ahead. And if perhaps you fear that at the crucial moment I will withdraw, then I rely on Allah. Even at that time, inshallah, you will find me among those that endure patiently. So the father is ready, the son is ready. Allahu Akbar. One is when I'm taking my son and we are going to the mazbah to slaughter, and my little child is talking, Abi, which sheep we going to buy and who's going to slaughter it, and I am happy and he is happy and we both are talking, and how he's excited how I'm going to slaughter, he's laughing, I'm entertaining him, it's a happy discussion that is going. But can we picture, fathom and comprehend when Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, Allahu Akbar, and his son are walking to that madbah, moments of silence, not delighted to say that we will bring the sheep and I will hold the legs and you will slaughter. No, it will be me. When that mother, Allahu Akbar, when that mother is bidding farewell to Ismail alayhi salam on the command of Allah, لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة. Indeed, in the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam and the galaxy of Anbiya alayhi salatu wassalam, they are like great signs for people of intelligence. أولئك الذين هدى الله فبهداه مقتدي. These are the guided people. Follow their footsteps and you will be on your way to Jannah. In these 10 days, Mubarak days, when the ummah was to steer one another in preparing themselves for qurbani, then how sad the Ummah is channeling their funds in Valentine gifts. At this crucial moment, the moments to revive, reflect, ponder, contemplate over the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. The mother sees her son off, knowing very well that there will be nobody to now call me Ummi. Allahu Akbar. This is a human weakness, and it is a human need that a person feels honored when he is addressed by his child. He can have all the titles. Mawlana Ashraf Ali Thanvi rahmatullah alayhi writes that I feel so happy when I come home. When I'm outside, sometimes it's Hazrat, sometimes it's Sheikh. When I come home, it's so nice to hear my mother say, Ashraf, come here quickly. That sweetness in the tone of my mother addressing me without any formalities is so beautiful. In the very same way, when the child says Ummi or Abi, then the entire tension of the day, a person is tired, is exhausted, but that sweet, innocent cry and call of the child is so beautiful that really words cannot describe it. The mother very well knows that this is now the end, that anybody will now be calling me Ummi. The child that has come after years, she greets the son greets the mother, and they leave. I'm going to stick to all authentic narrations. As they come to this place where Allah has now commanded for this supreme sacrifice to take place, the like of which neither the skies nor the earth has seen. Mufti Taqi Uthmani writes in his 11th edition on page 29 that the son then discusses with his father that, oh my father, now the time has come. Let me greet you, finish. Allah will unite us in Jannat. I fear that perhaps at the crucial moment when you will be slaughtering me and there will be eye contact, perhaps my love will overpower you and you will delay in responding to the command of Allah. Mufti Taqi Uthmani writes. So I suggest that perhaps you turn me around. Allahu Akbar. Brothers, it is time we put our Ismail down also. Our evil, our lies, our lust, our guna, our vice, our transgression. It cannot be that such a supreme sacrifice is taken from Ibrahim alayhi salam and Allah substitutes it only by one animal, which is only financial contribution and nothing else. There has to be something more to the sacrifice of that animal to revive the spirit of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Otherwise, we have not revived the spirit of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So, oh my father, let me turn my head down. And then Mufti Sahib writes, the Quran explains this beautiful. Falamma aslama wa tallahu lil jabeen. When both father and son, one tafsir, have become Muslim, and one tafsir, both have surrendered in totality. وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينِ and the son has put his head down. Brothers, when we think of what is happening to our Muslim brothers in Afghanistan, may Allah help them and protect them. Just as Allah gave victory to Ibrahim a.s. over Namrud, and to Musa a.s. over Fir'aun, and to Nabi a.s. over Abu Jahl, Allah's Qasam, very shortly the Ummah will witness the victory of this Ummah over the Fir'aun and the Abu Jahls of today. Let us not be demoralized or demotivated. Hatta idha stay'asa ar-rusul wa dhannu annahum qad kudhibu ja'ahum nasruna. Understand this verse of the Quran. Perhaps one of the most needed verses to be conveyed to the ummah is this verse at this time. When the ummah has been demoralized, what does Allah say? Allah says, when we decide to destroy a nation, then we give them such respite, such apparent delay, that two things happen by our delay. One is the kafir becomes convinced that there's no azab because there's so much delay. And the second thing that happens is that in the process, the believers appoint time in their own mind for the destruction of that kafir, but contrary to their hope, the azab does not come on their prescribed time. So they feel that, no, today he made such an evil statement, today Allah will destroy him. But it doesn't happen. Once, twice, thrice, after fixing times in your mind. It does not happen on the time that you thought it would happen. And so much delay that the kafir is convinced that there's nothing like azab. At this time, when the kafir feels there's no azab, and the believer knows there's azab, but I don't know when, Allah says, Ja'ahum nasruna. That's the time our azab comes. But as long as you and I feel this time or that time, it's not going to happen. At the time which is appropriate in the knowledge of Allah, which is complete and divine, at that time, and Allah says, when it comes, وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَأْسُنَا عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. Then our azab comes. وَلَقَدِ اسْتُهْزِئَ بِرُسُلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَأَمْلَيْتُ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا ثُمَّ أَخَذْتُهُمْ فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عِقَابٌ. So the very same thing is to happen, and Allah will show us, inshallah. Just as Allah has given victory to the various anbiya over their people, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam and Ismail alayhi salam, he puts his forehead down. Furthermore, Mufti Taqi Uthmani writes, he says that it comes in the narration that Ismail alayhi salam then made another appeal to his father. One is that you do not see me, so that when you slaughter in, my love does not overpower you, which must not result in delaying in the command of Allah. The second request I have, O my father, is that it is my human reaction that when you will slaughter me, I will kick. And when I will kick, my clothes will be stained with blood. And naturally, my mother would love to keep my outfit and my garment as a memory. I don't want to bring more pain to my mother when she will hold my kurta stained with blood. O my Abba, when slaughtering me, I will persevere, but hold me tight so my clothes are not messed with blood, so that I do not bring grief to my mother after I've left this world. The youth of today, let us reflect. Sayyidina Ismail is leaving this world considering the emotions of his mother. Has the time not come for the youth of this ummah to now consider the tears of their parents? Has the time not come for this ummah to give recognition and bear cognizance about the crying and the tears of their mothers in the early part of the morning? How long will we continue earning the wrath of Allah in this manner by displeasing our parents? The father has agreed, the son has agreed. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَيَّا إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Let us ponder. If we sit and think what is happening to our children in any other part of the world, just picture your son in that condition and a cold shiver will go down your spine. Your loving child, anybody stretching a nasty glance and you are ready to fight with that man and you are ready to angry, upset and do anything and everything within your reach to express your dislike for what he has done to your son. That is the love. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam. Not that they do not love. No, no, this is true love. The knife in his hand, on the command of Allah, and he starts slaughtering. Mawlana Ashraf Ali Thani rahmatullah alayhi writes, he doesn't only start slaughtering, he slaughters. And he explains it so beautiful. He says that the definition of slaughtering is imraru sikkin ala al-hulqum. To pass the knife on the neck, this is slaughtering. Now to be slaughtered, this is the effect of slaughtering, which has nothing to do with the reward or the punishment of any person. Just like everybody would agree that Namrud will be punished because he threw Ibrahim alayhi salam in the fire despite him not being burnt. Why? Because being burnt, this is the effect of the fire and this is subject to the Amr of Allah. But whatever was within his reach in showing his hatred, he went at the extreme length. Likewise, whatever was within the reach of Ibrahim alayhi salam in slaughtering his son, to that crucial moment of taking the knife and passing it on the neck of his son, Allah alone knows the level of iman, both father and son and mother combined of this khandan of nabuwat, that the combination of the sacrifice of father, mother and son put together has made this day a reality that Allah has given it place in the Quran and will be discussed in the day of Qiyamah. Immediately, when both father and son did what was within their reach, After all, Allah is so kind. Allah says, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. Allah doesn't allow you to kill your own self. Where is Allah going to allow you to slaughter your child? And if someone argues, the ulama have written, that if someone argues that no, Allah commands you to kill yourself in jihad, Mawlana Shafi'i Thanvi rahmatullah alayhi writes, that this is the lack of knowledge. He says, Allah doesn't command you to kill yourself in jihad. Allah commands you to take the lives of the kuffar. In the process, if your life goes, then persevere. But the object is to take the life of the kafir. And he substantiates this in the lines of the verse, يَقْتُلُونَ وَيُقْتَلُونَ, that they slay and then they are slain while slain. This is all ilmi kalam, of course. So Allah, Nabi alayhi salatu was salam, one person came to him and said, O Nabi of Allah, I love you. Nabi salallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Uqtul abak, go kill your father. He turned and Nabi alayhi salam says, come back. I don't allow you to severe ties. Where am I going to tell you to kill your father? I wanted to see how much love you had. That was the same sacrifice. Another incident of a sahabi comes to mind. Abdullah ibn Ubay bin Salul, the leader of the munafiqeen, his son Hazrat Abdullah radiallahu anhu. One day he came to Nabi alayhi salam. He was a sincere sahabi. He said, Ya Rasulallah, balagani annaka turidu qatla Abdullah ibn Ubay fima balagaka anhu. I have been informed that you intend to kill my father because of the wrong that he has done to you. In kunta fa'ilan famurni ahmilu ilayka ra'sahu. If this information that has reached me is true, then you give me this task, I will behead my father and I will come and put his head in your lap. Not because I hate my father. Look at the foresight of the sahabi. He writes, he says, O Nabi of Allah, I fear that you will not give me this task, knowing very well that it's my father. Inni akhsha an ta'mura bihi ghayri. You will tell someone else that go and kill Abdullah ibn Ubay. And that person happily will respond to kill my father, becoming beloved in your eyes and hated in my eyes, which I don't want must happen. فَلَا تَدَعْنِي نَفْسِي أَنْ أَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ قَاتِلِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ إِبْنِ أُبَيْ يَمْشِي فِي النَّاسِ. My emotions won't allow me to see the murderer of my father walking around. He is beloved to you and hated to me. How can this happen? Someone who is close to you. The only way out is, O Nabi of Allah, did you give me this task? I will behead my father so I don't have to hate anyone, and I will come and put his head in your lap. The Quran comes down immediately. لا تجد قوما يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر يوادون من حاد الله ورسوله ولو كانوا آباءهم أو أبناءهم أو إخوانهم أو عشيرتهم أولئك كتب في قلوبهم الإيمان. You will not find the true friends of Allah befriending the enemies of Allah, even if it means their fathers, their brothers, their relatives. These are those people in whose heart Iman has been embedded by Allah. Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam done their share. When he opens his eyes, Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam is smiling. The animal is slaughtered. Allah confirms. What does Allah say? Inna hadha lahu al-bala'u al-mubin. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Today we say we are tested, and this is a great test. Allah says, indeed, this was a great test that I put on Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Every one of us feels that today we have been tested severely by Allah. Allah Himself acknowledges in this ayat that indeed I have tested Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Now further, when Nabi alayhi salam is making mention of this incident of Qurbani, then the Sahaba ikram asked, مَا هَذِهِ الْأَضَاحِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. And we know مَا in Arabic is سُعَالَ عَنِ الْحَقِيقَةِ. What is the reality of this Qurbani? So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, Sunnatu abikum Ibrahim. It is the noble practice of your father Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. The question arises, what is the sunnat of Ibrahim alayhi salam? The slaughtering of the son or the slaughtering of the animal? The definition of sunnat is, ma dama alayhi nabiyyu. That which a nabi has done perpetually with consistency. If we analyze the slaughtering of the son, in essence, that did not take place. And slaughtering of the animal, it took place once. So on the definition of a sunnat, something which a Nabi has done continuously, neither of the two situations fit the definition of a sunnat, because slaughtering the animal happened once and slaughtering of the son did not happen, although Ibrahim alayhi salam will get the full reward. So what is then the sunnat of Ibrahim alayhi salam? The ulama ikram write, the sunnat of Ibrahim alayhi salam is neither slaughtering the son nor slaughtering the animal. But rather the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the practice of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the teachings of Ibrahim alayhi salam, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ دِينَ مِمَّنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنْ وَاتَّبَعَ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. The sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam is to submit in totality to the command of Allah, which was expressed in its greatest form on the occasion of the slaughtering of the son. So what is the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam? When Allah said submit, he said, oh my Lord, the delay is of your command. قرب نفسه للنيران وولده للقربان وزوجته للهجران فصار خليل الرحمن. He put himself in the fire on the command of Allah. He left his wife in that barren land. And look at his iman. After acknowledging that there's nothing there, he says, وَرْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ. He says, oh Allah, I've left them where there isn't a blade of grass. And then he says, oh Allah, you provide fruit for them. Now, respected brothers and elders, when Allah has been so kind that Allah has substituted the qurbani of the slaughtering of the son by one animal, and Allah is prepared to give us the same reward, this is such a great virtue that even if Allah did not make qurbani wajib upon us, just to acquire that qurbani, we should slaughter that animal. More so when Allah has made it wajib. Wajib in such stern words that the Nabi of Allah says, من وجد سعة لأن يضحي فلم يضحي. He who has the ability to slaughter that animal and then he mises and he does not slaughter. Nabi alayhi salam does not say, فَلَا يَحْضُرَنَّ مُصَلَّانَا فَلَا يَأْتِيَنَّ مُصَلَّانَا فَلَا يَجِئَنَّ مُصَلَّانَا فَلَا يَقْرُبَنَّ مُصَلَّانَا. Tell him, he must not even come close to our Eidgah. And if you study the riwayat, in the time of Nabi alayhi salam, at the Eidgah, when women used to come, even those women that were not performing salah, even they used to come to the Eidgah. Yet the Nabi of Allah said, that person who has the ability to sacrifice an animal and does not sacrifice, he should not even come close to our Eidgah. If a man has love for Nabi alayhi salam, then this will be enough for him to think, ponder and reflect. At least this amount that Allah is so kind that he is substituting it by an animal, that now when we are selecting that animal, let us select the best animal. When Allah has made it in place of our son and in place of our own nafs, let us select the best of animals. وَلَا تَيَمَّمُ الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِذُوا فِيهِ. And Allah says, what is best? Beautiful explanation. That which you don't want to accept, don't give it for Allah. How sad that so many times when we give charity, very commonly we say, it's of no use in the house, let's give it away in the house, in the path of Allah. That which is not fit for my use, or for my children, or for my wife, or for my house, that perhaps could be fit and enough for Allah. وَلَا تَيَمَّمُ الْخَيْرِ. Why? وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. Number one, he doesn't need it. He's been kind enough to accept it. At least honor the fact that he's accepting it, so present something that is beautiful. So this is the qurbani of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. His entire life revolving around the obedience of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And this is what this qurbani, this lesson, in the beginning I mentioned, derived from the word qurb. Qurb meaning the closeness of Allah. This qurbani has to bring us close to Allah. When we are putting that animal down, then there has to be something more than that animal. And that is that which is most beloved to us. It is time we put that knife on our evil. It is time we put that knife on our vices. And at the same time, not to forget Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he slaughtered that animal, according to one riwayat of Jam'ul Fawaid, he said, هَذَا عَمَّنْ آمَنَ بِي وَصَدَّقَنِي. This animal is on behalf of my ummah, those that are present, and those that will come and bring iman on me and believe in me till the day of Qiyamah. You and I were not born, but Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thought of us. If Allah has given us wealth, then this is the ideal opportunity to take one animal. And preferably, how sad that from the spirit of qurbani, from the house it went to the farm, and from the farm it went to overseas. And that's the end of qurbani. So our children don't know what is qurbani, but our children know what is birthday party. They know what is engagement. They know all these other occasions. Why? Because this has become common in our home. But qurbani happens abroad. So the day of qurbani, Allahu Akbar. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam did not for a moment think that when I will slaughter my son, My clothes will be stained with the blood of my son. How sad. Today's ummati, Allah knows our intention, is not slaughtering at home. Why? Because my yard will be messed with the blood of that animal. And we are claiming to revive the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam, who was prepared to stain his clothes with the blood of his own animal. Today we are not prepared to slaughter that animal at home. Why? My yard will get messed with the blood of that animal. What qurbani are we talking about, brothers? Are we sending it abroad because we're trying to help people on the other side, or we're getting away and we are looking for cheaper avenues? Inna Allah alimun bi dhati sudur. Allah knows what is in the heart. Nice, well and said, you gave here and there. Let us do this much, that wajib qurbani takes place at home. Nabi alayhi salam told Fatima, qumi, or Fatima, stand up. Tibi biha nafsa, look at your animal and stand there at the side of your animal and ask Allah to accept it. Allahumma taqabbalhu minni kama taqabbalta min sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa khalilika Ibrahim alayhi salam. When there is a wedding in the family, then the house is mess. Nothing is functioning normal. Everybody accepts it. The yard is dirty, the house is dirty, the rooms are messed up. Why? My daughter is getting married. If I'm not going to allow the people to come, my daughter will feel so offended that my mother is fussing about her house. How sad that Allah has brought the sacrifice of my mothers and sisters. My mothers and sisters, ponder and reflect over Hajira, who was ready to let go her son. Are we not ready to part with this house and belongings of ours? How long will this be the focus of our life, that my tiles and my blinds must mess, my house must be spick and span? Has the time not come that our hearts need to be clean? So let us bring that spirit of qurbani at home. Let that animal be brought at home. Let the entire family stand by the side of that animal. And if it can be done, purchase in advance some attachment with that animal, some closeness, so there's some spirit of sacrifice. We make dua to the Almighty Allah. He firstly give me the tawfiq and the ability of practicing on whatever has been said. May Allah give us, guide us, protect us. And may Allah give us the ability to implement all the injunctions of Quran and Hadith and revive the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Recite Durood Sharif. ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.